Good day, fellow investors. My name is Sven Karlin, and today I'll update you on Amira. Exactly 1 month ago, I published a video describing my long case for Amira, and the stock is now up about 40%. So there has been a lot of fuss about Amira. It became suddenly a hot stock after nobody was looking at it for a while. So I want to discuss a little bit, okay, what's my fair value, what's my target price, and what should be a fair intrinsic value of Amira, and what is the long-term fair value for Amira. In addition, as I always recheck my investments, check the data, the figures, I have rechecked Amira's balance sheet and book value, and I have an update on that also. That's very significant for Amira's margin of safety. Let's start with the new findings that increase Amira's margin of safety. Well, this is very important because you want to invest in companies that have huge value and high potential, thus low risk and high potential. What I found, thanks to a fellow subscriber sending me some info that I should relook this information, I went to check Amira's property, plant and equipment account on their balance sheet and to check what's really behind that account, behind those numbers. And there is a big imbalance, and it's a very positive imbalance. So stay tuned. If we take a look at Amphi's balance sheet, we can see that the last report shows 19.9 billion on property, plant and equipment. Amira's book value for that property, plant and equipment is around 35 million. Accumulated depreciation goes down to the current 19 million. According to Amira's SEC filing, Amira has a rice mill and some land. To be more precise on the land, it has 20 acres of land in Guargon, Haryana, India, and 48.2 acres in Kamal, also Haryana, a little bit more on the north from New Delhi. So Amira bought the 48.2 acres in Karnal to buy even more land there, which is owned by the Chanana family, the owner of Amira, in order to build a new processing plant that will increase throughput from 24 tons per hour to 60 tons per hour in order to facilitate growth, in order to buy more paddy, which when aged allows for higher margins. It's very smart what they are doing. I hope that in the next year, 2 years, Amira will be able to have some bond financing that will allow it to buy the land and then to continue to grow as planned before the short seller attacks. However, that land in Karnal, according to an independent report, is valued at $350,000 per acre. Summing it all up, 48.2 acres times $350,000 per acre, we come to about $16 million. So just an example here, I have found two plots in the nearby vicinity of Amphi's plot, and you can see that for 6.82 acres, the second one is 30 crores. One crore is $155,000, the other one is 7.75 crore acres for 9 crores. Thus, the first one is $180,000 per acre, the second one is $681,000 per acre. The first is for a school, the second is for a rice mill. Thus, this could also lead to double Amphi's value, but let's take the $350,000 per acre as proper value for the mill, thus we keep the 16 million. The part of land that's even more interesting is the land in Guargon, close a little bit south from New Delhi, where Amphi has its own current mill now. Those are 20 acres in Guargon, Haryana, India. You can just type it in Google Maps and you will find Free Amira Foods India, of which one is the rice mill close to New Delhi. Now, what's very interesting is that Amphi's 20 acres of land are very close to new developments being built, new residential developments. Now, I remind myself that the management's target was to sell this plot after building the new plot in Karnal. This would allow Amphi to receive a huge chunk of money for this land and process more rice in the future. So, What's really interesting about Amphy is that the management is smart, value creating, and long-term value creation oriented. Just the management you want in place. Where is Amphy's mill? 40 kilometers south from New Delhi. Now, I have looked a bit around, and one of the new developments is Godre Oasis. It looks like this, so very modern, very expensive flat. I have found similar land plots that are priced at 3.4 million per acre, the above one, 20 acres for 250 crores, and 2.9 million per acre for the 9 crores per acre, the lower one. We have 20 acres times $3.5 million per acre goes to 68 million for the value of the land. 68 million plus the 16 million, according to my calculation, is $84 million. $84 million minus the 20 that are on the book value, that are on the balance sheet, is $64 million. Divided by the number of shares, 35 million, you get a value of $1.8 per share to be added to the already higher than stock price book value. Thus, we have just increased Amphy's margin of safety. I always tell my students, never trust numbers on the balance sheet. Always go beyond the number. See what's really beyond that number, what really makes that number. And in this case, it is high land values. Sometimes there is nothing, but in this case, it's a positive. Now, we have added almost $2 per share on Amphy's margin of safety. And this is also very important because now I understand that Amphy will not have liquidity issues, because when you have such a collateral, Indian banks will give them money easily because they know they will get the money back. If Amphy would liquidate now, we have the book value 7.71 plus 1.8 plus the margin on the sold rice, which should be relatively strong because basmati prices went up. I think that the liquidation value for Amphy now is at least $12. So there is a huge margin of safety and a huge upside potential to reach a fair value. So what's the fair value for a company like Amphy? So we have liquidation value of $12. We have earnings that are expected to be around 1.5 for next year and then continue growing as Amphy has been growing in the past. How fast has Amphy been growing? Well, in 2012, revenues were 330 million, they are now 575 million, and with the higher basmati prices, they will be around 800 million next year. So in 6 years, Amphy will have grown revenues for 142%, thus 15% per year. And with all the new developments, building the new rice mill, distribution centers across India, we can easily expect that to continue in the future. So what's Amphy's fair value? Liquidation value is $12. Earnings per share are $1.5. I want a 10% return on my investment. Given Amphy is growing at 15% per year, I'm willing to go a little bit lower. So I would attach a fair price earnings ratio of 12 to Amphy's earnings. 1.5 times a price earnings ratio of 12, we get a fair value of around 18. Thus, still a long way to go. Now, this is me. I have much stronger criteria than normal investment funds, pension funds, index funds. A look at the Nifty, the Indian price earnings ratio, will show us that Indian companies, thanks to the economic growth, thanks to their business growth, are priced much, much higher than Amphy. The average price earnings ratio in the past has been around 20 and now is at 25. $1.5 of earnings times a price earnings ratio of 25, Amira's fair market value would be around 37.5. There can be a lot of debate whether the Indian stock market is overvalued, but given the huge economic growth, that's very debatable. So let's say a 20 price earnings ratio would be fair, then we see Amira at 30. Is it possible? If everything that the management has started doing if the next timely published annual report leads to rating and then leads to a bond issue, then we can sure expect wonderful things for Amira. So don't get too excited on the 30% stock price increase. That's just the start. Amira can really become a nice 5 to 10 bagger in the next year or two. Subscribe, because I'll be discussing more about Amira, about the long-term basmati prices cycle, how that affects the company, their basmati prices and margins, how will a new mill affect the company with higher earnings, higher potential earnings due to higher margins. So there's a lot to talk. We'll first wait for the earnings report end of the month. I'll analyze that, and when I have more time somewhere in August, I'll go on with the analysis on the basmati sector, their margins, and so on. There's plenty more to learn about Amira and to follow. Let's hope the stock price follows our learning curve. Thank you for watching. Share this video, leave your comments below, and I'll see you in the next video.